Truchas is primarily a Hispanic village of approximately 1,000 people, located within a 15,000-acre Spanish land grant, the Nuestra Señora del Rosario, San Fernando, y Santiago. This grant was established by petition to the Spanish king in 1754 by 12 families who established the Plaza of Truchas. Nestled high in the Sangre de Cristo Mountains, Truchas sits at an elevation of 8,051 feet. The town site has homes and businesses along the main road, for which many years was a dirt road. Born in December 1930, José Domingo Sandoval was the sixth of 12 children born to Apolinar and Pablita López Sandoval. The Sandoval family and extended family was large, with plenty of kids to help work the farm. Farming has been a part of my ancestry for many generations, and today I got a glimpse of Dad's life on the farm growing up in Truchas. I followed my dad to Las Joyas, the land where Dad played and worked as a young man, where arrowheads were as common as small rocks, where we walked to feed the cows this sunny spring morning. Dad pointed to a cow. "First time I've seen a cow that didn't like her calf. She didn't even dry it. I made a bottle. They have to suck from the cow within 24 hours after birth." He proceeded to get hay from the white trailer and explained to me that he feeds the cows twice a day. "This year I've been feeding them 4 bales of hay, enough to survive so they are not too thin. I'll take them the 1st of May or the 15th, depending on the pasture in the forest. It has to be a certain height, and I leave them till the end of September." Dad learned young, at age 6, to butcher cattle with his father. After feeding the cows, I asked my dad if we could go for a ride around Truchas, and he gladly agreed. We got into his truck and drove east toward the mountains where Dad was going to show me the Acequia Posesión. As we rode, we passed his land to the south. The truck ride on the dirt road was bumpy. We talked about family along the way. "Tell me about life as a young boy," I asked. "I think our folks were used to the land. They were raised that way. They had to work to survive. They raised corn, beans, you name it, anything that grows on the land. We would start milking the cows in the morning, feed the cows, pigs, chickens, and water them. I would get water for mother from the ditch for the rest of the day because we didn't have running water. And after breakfast, we would have hoeing to do." Chores like these were common for farming families. For fun, Dad and his siblings made their own sleds and played in the snow and ice. Religion was very important at home, and it was Grandma that taught catechism to the kids. She was very strict when it came to religion. School was not far from his house, La Cuestacita, where he attended until 7th grade. After that, he went to 8th grade in another school across the street from the Tafoya's General Store. In 1949, Dad graduated from Santa Cruz High School. Fishing and hunting were a big part of my dad's life. Dad described fishing with his dad on horseback to the Rio Quemado and Rio Medio. "We used to bring hundreds. We would give some to the neighbors," he chuckled. We arrived at the Acequia Posesión and walked the dirt path toward the Compuerta, the head gate of the Acequia. "We're about 14 members now. There used to be 32 when I was growing up. We distribute the water based on the acreage that each owner has, and it's the same when it comes to work. No one wants to serve as mayordomo. It's a headache, a lot of responsibility, hard work, no pay. My dad is a treasurer of this Acequia and also has the responsibility to let owners know when they will have their water. He has the cycle of watering down to a science. Once you open the water, you let it go until you don't need it. Usually by August, people are cutting and baling their hay, so there's no need for water."
This acequia, this water that we get here, the best portion of the water comes from the North Fork of the Rio Quemado.
"How has life changed since you were young?" I asked him. "It's changed mostly with few people taking an interest in working the land. It's hard to work the land. The respect that there used to be among people, young people respecting the elders, now has changed totally. Like I was raised, we didn't have anything. We had to work to survive. Poor, yes, in money, but we had plenty to eat.
And like a lot of people tell me, well, why do you work so hard? Your life, you're not going to take anything with you. I know I'm not going to take it with me, but I've enjoyed it while I have